a walk.
He was walking up and down Broadway.
I was looking,
had an eye out for a swell cafe.
I was hungry,
he was sounding for a bite to munch.
I found a spot,
he took a table at the merchant's lunch.
Oh, the merchant's lunch, it was an ocean of gloom.
It looked like
half past midnight in the afternoon.
Down by the bar,
the breakfast manager was pouring suds
for the boys,
the railways, cowboys, and their goodwill does.
And the girls,
the pride of fennel, pushing pinball queens,
chewing gum,
sweaty combat.
Broadway Brenda and her derelict cart.
I ordered the blue plate special and peered out through the room to see what class of citizens inhabited this gloom. And the hapless visages I saw were innocent of cheer, though mirthless laughter filled the air, inspired by wine and beer. Helpless accidents of fortune's careless aim, Broadway Brenda rose upon her queen-size 6-foot frame. I turned away to shun her eyes, but I knew it was too late when a hand fell on my shoulder as my gaze fell on my plate. I looked her up and over,
and she did the same to me.
Her teeth were
green as garden bees.
She shaped her hair
with dishpan fingertips.
An earthquake of excitement
shook her crack of toe and hips.
Her hands went to her bosom, a hush fell on the crew.
And take her up, Brenda lay exposed to view.
These fevered words she whispered
as he gazed upon the scene.
It's the custom here at Merchant's Lunch,
entertain the queen.
I grabbed my hat,
and in an instant he was on.
I was sober as a judge
down at the county seat.
He kept his diesel up to 80, went past Baton Rouge,
made it back to Beaumont for the evening news.
He owns a white load rig,
I pay thousands in tax.
He's gonna keep it in Texas,
I ain't leaving for snacks.
He's a driving fool,
the interstate belongs to me, but I'm never going back.
Like
half past midnight in the afternoon.